I would just like to give a few examples from the South to show that this phenomena of trying to preserve and protect the deities was not a North Indian affair. It was as widely prevalent in the South as in the North. What happens in the South is, firstly, the large scale burial of bronzes that takes place. I will discuss this phenomena a little later, but first address the situation in some important temples. The first temple I will take is the Sri Ranganath temple. Everybody has heard of the Sri Ranganath temple. It was first attacked by Malik Kafur. Now, that was the first time that a temple was being attacked in the South, and the priests and the devotees had never visualized that such a thing could happen and were totally unprepared. So, by all accounts, they were not able to protect the image, which was destroyed, which seems to have been destroyed. Some decades later, the Sri Ranganath temple was attacked a second time, this time by Prince Muhammad bin Tughlaq, when he was not Sultan. And this time, when the temple authorities were informed that the Sultanate forces are marching towards the temple, they were better prepared. So what they did was, the Garbhgriha, where the Sthapit Murti was, they put up big stones in front of that to give the impression that there was nothing behind and this was the wall. And the Utsav Murti, they ran away with the Utsav Murti. And there are temple histories of Sri Ranganath which tell us where were the pandits or the priests ran to protect the image. They went to various places over decades, and finally, as a safety, they reached Kerala. When they reached Kerala, they were shocked to discover the priests of so many temples of the South had come to Kerala with the deities or icons. So gradually, by various processes, they finally reached Tirupati, because the Sultanate armies had not reached Tirupati till that time. And when they reached Tirupati, that is the home of Lord Venkateshwar, then the priests said that we are very happy and honored that Sri Ranganath has come to our temple, and they created a special small temple in the Venkateshwar temple for Sri Ranganath. If you go to Tirupati, then you will find a small building called Rang Mandap. Rang Mandap was created in this period as the temple for Sri Ranganath. And he was kept there with great honor. He was, prayers were offered to him. Everything was done for him. Some decades later, Gopana. Who was Gopana? He was associated with the Vijayanagar prince Kamben. So he comes to Tirupati on a darshan and he finds Sri Ranganath there. So he asks the priests of the Venkateshwar temple, can I take this deity back? They said, all right. So he takes it back to his kingdom, and about a decade later, he reinstates it in the Sri Ranganath temple. And if you go to the Sri Ranganath temple, there is an inscription which Gopana put up on the wall of the temple, saying that I am the one who bought this deity, who bought Lord from Tirupati and got him reinstated in his home in this year, on this date, at this time. So that entire history is there.